Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan for his children and your rescue. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. Walk with us that path, that narrow path, towards his holy mountain, where we will all meet together as a multitude closed and wide, where the angels will take us from the four corners of the earth towards that mountain, where we will have access to the holy place, to the throne of his glory, where we will be raptured into paradise and be with the Father and Jesus Christ forever and ever. My name is Michael, and I am the founder of Triple Grace at the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today our topic is, do what Jesus did. Sometimes I'm asking myself why it is so difficult for the people to understand what is written in the Bible. Then I will come always back to one point, and that is legalism. When I hear people say, oh, you have to do this and you have to do that, and you cannot eat meat and you cannot eat that, and you cannot perform this one, and you have to do all these things, and it must be Sabbath, and it must be Saturday, and it must be Sunday, and it must be this and that. That is all legalism. Why can you not read the Bible and use the example that the Lord has shown you? He went out to the people, to the lost sheep every day. He was teaching them through parables. He was talking to them through the divine stories. He was bringing forth the love of the Father to the people. And then, in the book of Acts, you see the assemblies of love and righteousness. How they became part of the societies, and everybody loved them because they were generous. They lifted up the needy. They did nothing wrong. And they stayed together in love, unity, and support. They shared resources. They were a great example for all to see. That is the reason why Christianity grows so fast and so big. Because they made a good appearance in the beginning. But now, I see only legalism. Oh, you must follow my denomination. You must be Presbyterian, or you must be whatever. No, you do not have to follow a religion. Jesus is not about religion. He is about love. He is about his Father's business, his Father's kingdom. His economy, winning of souls. He is not about a denomination, a religion, or a fixed idea about that you cannot do this and you cannot do that. I see men on YouTube and their beards are growing longer and longer, and their hairs are getting longer and longer because I have read somewhere in the Bible that you should not cut your hair nor your beard. Legalism. This will not save you. I've seen, oh, you cannot eat meat. It will not save you. Has not even Peter himself, as a true Jew, received the dream that he should eat from anything? Has Jesus not said, it does not matter what comes into your stomach because it will go out again? What matters is what is in your heart and what comes out of your mouth. What are you speaking? That is important. Everything else is legalism. You will be surprised if you could ask the Father how he would look at people. And you would surprise when he say, even people who have never read the Bible and have never heard about Jesus Christ will go to heaven because the Father is judging your heart. And you can do exactly what Jesus did, even without having known his name or having known his story. You can do that. And then you have the heart like Jesus. And then you will be in heaven and you will be raptured into paradise. Even without having seen the Bible and without having known Jesus Christ. But then the legalist people will come, no, you cannot. Because there's one verse written that you have to, can only come through Jesus Christ to the Father. Why? Because he is a son. So what you should become is a true son and daughter of the Most High. You should copy what Jesus did. That's the reason why he is the truth, the way, and the life. Do what Jesus did. Do not lift Peter or Paul in their letters to the first believers over Jesus. There are many people who are living a gospel of Paul and living a gospel of Peter and stand to live like Jesus. They have lifted up the disciples over the master. That's legalism. That's false interpretation. Become like Jesus. Become a true son and or daughter of the Most High. Do what he did. Go for the lost sheep. Preach to them. Show them the love of the Father. Show them the kingdom of heaven. Be an example, an active example every day. Do not sit in churches and be engulfed of legalism. Whatever religion you follow, whatever denomination you are in, whatever you are eating, that will all not save you. You are saved through grace by faith. Alone. And then your heart will start to feel sin. Then your heart will start to tell you, we have to go here to help these people. We have to change this world. And this is what I call the following works after salvation. You are saved. But then you will do the righteous deeds of the saints. Because these righteous deeds of the saints will then give you the white clothes that are required to enter heaven. That will make you pure and without spot and wrinkle. So copy what Jesus did, not what Paul did, not what Peter did, not what anybody else did, what Jesus did, so that you become a true son and daughter of the Most High. Understand finally that no Bible verse and no legalism and no religion and no denomination and no any of the other stuff that is there, not a long beard or a long hair or a Sabbath or anything else, will save you. Just do what Jesus did. Copy his ways and become a true son and daughter of Yahweh, of the Father. Show forth Father's business to the world. Show forth his love to the world. And for that purpose, we have established societies of the Rose, the assemblies of love and righteousness of old. And you can join us, and you can establish your own in your neighborhood. And you can walk, act, and talk as Jesus did every day. Not only once a week go to church. No. This is a full-time ministry. And your Society of the Rose will be a full-time ministry. Because you will be a full-time son or daughter of the Most High. Not a churchgoer on Sunday, then back into the world. Because as a follower of Yahweh, you will be outside of the world and outside of Babylon. That's the reason why we call you to come out in the great Exodus. To walk that path to Mount Zion. And on that way, you will be a full-time minister in your Society of the Rose, and you will gather the people together with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, in love, unity, and support. There's no other way than the way of Jesus. But it's not as most people think it is. It is, you should do what he did. Copy his ways. Take the cross and walk as he did. For the Father and in the name of the Father and not in your own. Not in legalism, not in fighting and backstabbing about Bible verses or religion or denominations. No, in love, unity, and support, as the true sons and daughters of the Most High. So from today forward, do as Jesus did, and walk as he did, and become a true son and daughter of Yahweh. Thank you that you have listened to this teaching today. I know I'm stepping on many toes. I know. Many people will not come out of that legalism because they're bound by Satan for so long. I'm just here as a lone voice, tell you the truth so that you can walk in spirit and truth towards Mount Zion, towards the holy place, so that you will be raptured into paradise, that your mansion is guaranteed to walk with us. And if somebody will look at you and he will see a small Jesus, a copy of Jesus, a small one, then you have done the right steps. Because you have acted and done as Jesus did. Always, whatever you do, ask, what would have Jesus done in my situation? Look through his eyes to the world, and you will see all that darkness. And you will run away from the world. And you will come and take my hand and join us at Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation, and you will walk with us. Of course, we can only show you that open door, and you will step through it, but then you have to walk alone, together with your mighty angel. We can only show you that door, but we are here for you. If you need any support, just send us an email. Because we love you all dearly, and we do not want that even one sheep is get lost. We do not want that Satan will remain with even one pearl, because the pearls are belonging to the Father. Please, come out of your legalism and walk that way of Jesus, that path, the only path. There's only path of Jesus. And this has nothing to do with legalism, no religion, no denominations, no long beards or long hairs. Your beard grows longer and longer, but you are still stuck in bondage to Satan. It will not help you. What will it help you if you know the Bible off head, but you are not living like Jesus did? Then at the end, Jesus will tell you, I do not know you. Please, come together with us. Support us. Let this message come forth. Let the message be brought to all the nations, to all the people. Therefore, we need your support, your help. Alone, we cannot make it. I am just a lone voice. But you can lift up Triple Grace, and you can bring us onto that path everywhere, on all continents, and into all nations, into all towns. And we can gather the people in love, unity, and support with your help. Open your heart. This month of July is a month of love and compassion. So show your acts of loving kindness and send us your assistance, your support. The links are in the description box below. Time has come. You are called forth to enter your destiny and your purpose. Let us do this together, powerfully, as Jesus did, as the true sons and daughters of the Most High. Thank you. Thank you for all of your donations that will come in. Thank you for all supporters. Thank you for all patrons of Triple Grace. Thank you for all. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that you will come back again tomorrow for the next teaching. My name is Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And I am the lone voice that is calling you out the world and out of Babylon. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.